In this video, you'll learn how to develop functionality that requires a user to confirm their email address before they can log in. Once they sign up, they'll have to click on a link in an email to activate their account. If they don't do that, they can't log in. We'll be building on the code created in the previous videos, where we developed signup, login, and password reset functionality. So if you haven't seen those yet, there are links in the description. All the code developed in this video is freely available, and a link to that is also in the description. Currently, when a user signs up for an account, they provide their details, including an email address. Once they've done this, we create an account in the database, and they can sign in. We're using the user's email address to uniquely identify them. When they sign up, we're validating the format of the email address, but not that the email address actually exists, and that the user signing up has access to that email account. So they could just enter any old value in order to create an account and log in. We'll fix this in a similar way to the password reset functionality we developed in the previous video. When a user signs up, we'll generate a unique token and store this in the database with their user record. We'll call this an account activation token. While their account is associated with one of these tokens, we won't let them log in. After signing up, we'll send them an email that contains a link that includes this token. When they click on the link, we can identify their account from the token and remove it from their user record. Then they'll be able to log in and we'll know that the email address they've provided exists and they have access to it. First, let's add a column to the user table in the database to store the account activation token. We'll call the new column account activation hash. This will be a 64-character varchar that accepts null values and has a default value of null. We'll also specify a unique index on this column, as we'll be using this column in a where clause. Let's click save, and there's the new column and the index. A script containing the SQL to add this column is in the code repository for this video. A link is in the description. As for the code, we'll start with the password reset code from the end of the previous video. If you need this, you can get it in this repository. If you do install it from here, don't forget to install the PHP mailer library using Composer. We are inserting a new record in the user table in the process-signup.php script. To enable the email confirmation functionality, the first thing we need to do is generate a unique token and store it in the column we just added to the user table. In the previous video, when we developed the password reset functionality, we did something similar in the sendPasswordReset.php script. Here, we're generating a random token and its hash. So let's copy these two lines and paste them in the processSignup.php script before we insert the record. Let's rename these to activation token and activation token hash. Then, let's add the account activation hash column to the field list in the SQL string, along with an associated placeholder. Then, when we bind values to the parameters, let's add another S character to the type string parameter for the token hash, and then the activation token hash variable for its value. Let's give that a try. If I sign up with valid data, we see the sign up success page. In the database, there's the new record, and the account activation hash column contains the token hash value. The signup success page shows a message saying we can now log in. However, we now need the user to confirm their email address before we can let them do this. In the signupsuccess.html page, let's change this message, so now it says the user has to confirm their email address first, and removing the link to the login page. Next, we can send the account activation email. Again, in the send password reset script, we're sending an email using the mailer code we developed in the previous video. So let's copy this code and paste it in the process signup script before we redirect to the signup success page. In this script, we don't have a variable for the email, so we'll change this to the value in the post array. Let's change the subject to account activation. In the body of the message, let's change the URL to activateaccount.php, a script which we'll add in a moment. Let's also change the token variable to the activation token variable we created above, and the text of the message. Note that I've hard-coded example.com here as the hostname. In practice, you'd probably have this as a variable, so you can change it when you change servers. But to keep it simple in this video, I'll leave it like this. Then, as we're redirecting immediately after this, I'll just add an exit statement after this line in the catch block so we can see what the error message is if the email isn't sent. Note that if you're doing this from a fresh install of the previous code, you'll need to change the settings in the mailer.php script to your SMTP server settings. Let's give that a try. If I sign up with valid data, now the signup success page no longer has a link to the login page, and it shows the updated message. In the email client, there's the account activation email containing the link to the activate account page. So next, let's add that page. We're doing something similar in the resetpassword.php script. Getting the token from the query string, looking up a user based on its hash, and so on. So let's make a copy of this page and call it activateaccount.php. In here, we want to get the token from the query string and calculate its hash. Then we'll look up a user record in the database using that hash, but with a where clause on the account activation hash column instead. Then we bind the hash value to the placeholder and retrieve the user record from the database if there is one. If no user record was found with the supplied token hash, then we're currently stopping the script with a message. To keep it simple, we'll leave this message as it is. We don't need this code that checks the token expiry though, so we'll remove it. At this point, we've got a valid user record that corresponds to the activation token we sent in the email. So now we can update that record to set the activation token hash column to null. So let's write the SQL to do that with a where clause with a placeholder on the user ID. We'll create a prepared statement, bind the user ID value to the placeholder, and execute it. Once we've done this, we can display a message saying the account has been activated. So in the HTML below, let's change the title and the heading. We don't need the form, so let's remove that and replace it with a message, including a link to the login page. There's one more thing we need to do, and that's to disable login until the account has been activated. So in the login.php script, first we're selecting the user record based on the email address. If a valid user record is found, then we check the password. So in the condition where we check to see if the user exists, let's add a condition to this, checking that the account activation hash column is null. So we'll only check the password and allow login if that column is null. That column will only be null if the account has been activated. Let's give that a try. I'll sign up for a new account with valid data. And we get the sign up success message. Before we activate the account, let's try logging in with this new account. And we get invalid login. In the database, the account is there, but the activation token hash isn't null. In the email client, there's the account activation email. If I click on the link, we see the account activated page, with a link to the login page. Now in the database, the activation token hash column has been set to null. So now that we've activated the account, we can successfully log in. There's a link to all the code shown in this video in the description. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and as always, thank you for watching.